Well, you might remember my next guest and his friends. Norm Gershens is the director of SaveNature.org, a San Francisco nonprofit that educates people about insects and their natural habitats. And Norm is back with us today, and he brought some wonderful favorite insects of his to show off. We had a great time a couple of years ago. People always commented, like, I actually got to hold some of these guys, and it was fun, actually.
Well, it is fun, and I have to tell you that you're going to hold things today that you never, never thought you'd ever hold.
I'm sure of that. I'm sure of that. What do we have?
Well, the Insect Discovery Lab, as I was going to remind you, goes out to schools all across the Bay Area, reaches about 38,000 children every year. Wow. We do 800 programs.
You also do behind the scenes, as if people call you up, they want to come to you. You have a whole hour and a half program with
us. We have a very special behind the scenes tour that is held at our lab. The people that come to that, they see things that we never bring out. But I did bring some things today for you to see.
Okay, and that's a good preview for what people can do when they see
exactly.
you.
Exactly. So the first thing I'm going to show you is Australian walking stick. It's totally harmless, but what you're seeing, what you're thinking, wait a minute, it looks just like a scorpion.
The tail is...
Yes, and it's supposed to. It mimics a scorpion.
Wow.
Are you kidding me? Here's this Australian walking stick. Something comes up to it and says, you are perfect lunch. And she rolls up her abdomen and says, I don't think so.
And
put your hands flat.
It scares people away.
And this is, so this animal, it loves to be very still, but it does this little rocking motion as if it's in the leaves. So here it is sitting perfectly still and just rocking a little bit, oftentimes underneath the leaf, but look, it has that.
What is this?
That's its front foot.
Oh.
That's its little tarsi at the end, so it holds on. In fact, if you were to turn your hand slowly, 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 keep going, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. Turn it upside down.
No.
Completely upside down, yes.
No.
Yes. And there she is.
How can she do that?
Completely upside down, holding on, and that's why you don't see them when you're walking in the rainforest.
Wow.
Because they're under the leaves at night.
That's
perfect.
Unbelievable. And it looks like a leaf.
Just like a leaf. Sometimes even people say it looks like the ginger that's in the rainforest. But this is a spectacular animal for children to hold.
This is
You
great.
Put this in a child's hand or an adult's
yes.
hand. And the next thing they're thinking, I must save this place in nature.
Okay.
Indeed.
Do you name these guys?
No, we don't name them. Because, you know, and there's a reason why, you know, because there are animals, we have some that live for a long time and some live for a short time. I have another animal that very few people see unless you have gone to Madagascar.
Oh.
This is the Madagascar hissing cockroach.
I've heard of these guys.
And they're very friendly, very sweet, but if we're lucky, and it's hard to know if we're going to be lucky today, this is a male, and they make a hissing sound to protect themselves. Put your hand flat, nice and flat. Sometimes when I put them, hold them. Nope, didn't hear it, but I'll try again.
Oh, I heard it.
No, hold on. There we go. And there he is. He's beautiful. And I have to say, I was disappointed when they did the movie Madagascar. I don't think they had hissing cockroaches.
No, they did not.
So I do, let's see if I have another one here that might hiss. Keep holding that one.
Well, he did hiss a little bit, but I could just barely hear it. He's shiny.
Yes.
Oh, what's that?
This is a female, and she's a little different. Let's see if I can put them together just for a moment. Nothing will happen.
She's a little more active.
I know that the children might be watching. But the female's a little different because she has a smooth back. And these animals are so important for nature because they are the decomposers. So who's moving all the food that sits on the bottom of the forest floor?
You know, we have an aversion to cockroaches. Just the name itself absolutely gives people the willies.
I know. It's true. And roaches, you know, but these animals, the Madagascar hissing cockroach, only occurs on one place.
We have to move on.
Okay.
Boy.
I know I never did bring anything with eight legs last time.
Okay.
So I brought something this time that is very few people ever see. It's harmless. It looks quite ferocious.
Why do they all look so mean?
No, they're beautiful. This is called a whip scorpion. Now, scorpion's a terrible name.
Yes.
It's a common name because all true scorpions have a stinger.
Okay.
This one's totally harmless, but it does have this tail to protect
itself. It looks like an antenna.
It does, but actually these front legs are more like antennas. They're sensing their environment. They're almost blind.
And look at the claws.
That's its mouth. And
what?
So it's a predator. It eats other animals, only comes out at night. And so if it's frightened, it releases acetic acid, which is vinegar. So it's also called a vinegaroon. Put your hand flat.
Okay.
This is a great animal to hold. It's totally harmless. There you go.
Oh, he's very light.
Very light indeed.
Very light.
And so to find these, you have to go to the deserts of Arizona.
I bet you they camouflage well because look at his color.
Well, they're out at night. Too,
okay.
And so they're very hard to see.
All right.
But indeed, I have to tell you that vinegar works. It's 95% strong. The vinegar you and I eat is only 5% strong.
Wow.
So the vinegaroon is effective. But I have, you're the only person and probably the only TV show I've ever shown this to, if I can find her quickly.
Okay.
Let's see. Here she is. This is the relative of the vinegaroon, and it's called a tailless whipped scorpion. We're not going to hold her, but if you get a close-up, you'll see that she has these very, very, very long front legs.
Look how skinny and long they are.
And they are often found under bark or in caves.
And look how flat the body is.
Yeah, so they can move very quickly under the bark. A tailless whipped scorpion.
That is unbelievable. And the claws here are just kind of flat like that.
Exactly. So they're predators as well. You're probably the only one ever to see it.
Wow. Thank you. I don't have to touch it.
And if you come to the lab, you can see these in the behind
Excellent.
The scenes. Yes.
All right. We have time for, I think, is it one more?
Okay.
Maybe two
let's
more?
Let's see what we have.
Okay.
All right.
So when we come to the lab, you give us all of these instructions. And how do you collect these guys?
Well, some of them we breed in captivity.
Okay.
And so we breed them at the lab. And I'm going to show you a very sweet, I have a couple of these. Put your hand flat. This is called a death feigner beetle because it plays dead.
Oh my God.
All of them, all of them.
He plays dead.
They just
Look
play.
Look at that.
They
That's
just play
incredible.
Dead. And so when you see them in nature, they just,
oh,
they're okay. That's okay. Ah. They play dead. And that's a great strategy for protecting
And the
yourself.
Name again is the blue?
The death feigner.
The death feigner.
Beaner,
all right.
Beetle.
Let's let people know that Norm is inviting every one of us to visit him at his lab. And these are very unusual creatures to see. So if you want to find out, go to savenature.org or call 415-648-3390. It sounds like a lot of fun. Adults also have a good time, not just kids. And of course, all guest information will be on our website at ktvu.com. Just go to the KTVU TV36 menu tab and look for community. And don't forget to join us on Facebook to find out what's going on behind the scenes, and you see photographs of all of these bugs. So thank you very much for joining us. And you know, Norm, it's always fun. And this is a nonprofit
yes.
venture
yes.
for you.
And we have a very special fundraiser coming up in April.
Yes, tell
April,
people about
April
that.
April 26th, we have Bowl the Planet at Classic Bowling. It's from 5 to 8 p.m. It's in the dark. It's under black light, like the scorpions.
Uh-huh.
And it raises money to create scholarships to bring the Insect Discovery Lab out to children.
Because you go to schools all over the Bay Area.
800 schools in the Bay Area.
All right. We'll give information about the bowling night, too. Thank you for being
Thank
here.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us. And we've run out of time, so thanks for watching. We'll see you again next week right here on Bay Area People. So until then, I'm Rosy Chu. Have a terrific weekend. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.